Welcome back to Latest News with me, Yael Broya. Bob Smytherman is the official town crier for Worthing, a role reintroduced by the Worthing Town Centre Initiative in 2014, helping to promote the town and its events and activities. Mike Mendoza sat down with him to find out more.
Well, it's not just Brighton that has elections this year, Worthing does as well. Worthing has 13 wards, 11 are up for grabs, or one seat in each ward anyway, so that's 11 seats in Worthing this year. All parties appear to be involved this year. The list is already out. There's Greens, there's UKIP, Labour, Conservative and Lib Dem, of course. In a moment, I'm going to be talking to a gentleman who's been a Lib Dem councillor on Worthing Council, in fact, the longest serving councillor on the council. He's also a county councillor, as well, of course, as being the town crier. We're going to talk to Bob Smytherman in a moment. Well, politics have changed since you first got involved, of course, so over the years.
Indeed, yeah, I was first elected to this council back in 2002, Mike, and yeah, it's a very different place. But one thing that is still very similar, of course, is successive governments continue to take more and more funding away from local government, making decisions very, very difficult for whoever's running councils.
So is this going to be the main issues this year in the election?
Absolutely. It's, you know, council resources is always a huge issue, and we've got a huge issue at the moment, of course, with the refuse collection changes. The Conservatives promised last year that, and they were very proud of their weekly bin collections, and now soon after the elections last year, they decided to do a U-turn and introduce an alternative weekly collection, which I think is a retrograde step. Uh-huh. And if we're serious about recycling, of course, we need to make sure we recycle every week rather than alternate weekly for both collections.
I noticed that virtually every party is standing this time around. You've got the Greens, you've got UKIP, Lib Dem, Conservative, Labour. So you're all in there just for 11 seats.
Absolutely. Obviously, all the candidates were released online last night. No huge surprises, really. Obviously, the Liberal Democrats always fight all the seats, along with the Conservatives and the Labour Party. The Greens and UKIP normally struggle to fight all the seats.
The Greens never won a seat in Worthing, have they?
Greens, they did. James Doyle held the seat for 4 years and lost it to Labour last year in Central Ward. So that's the only time the Greens have had a seat in Worthing.
Are you surprised that so many UKIP are standing this year as well?
I am, actually, considering Nigel Farage setting up his new party, which I think is possibly a party now, the Brexit Party. I'm surprised that sort of UKIP are still going. But, of course, they do have one elected councillor still on this council. I guess it's probably a bit of a last throw of the dice for them, yeah. Ahead of, obviously, the sort of national politics that's going on.
They won quite a few last time, didn't they, UKIP? Well, they've had a few seats.
One or two here and there. Yeah. Their last councillor actually was re-elected last year as a Conservative. Charles James, the former mayor, was elected to UKIP in a by-election, but he gone back to the Conservatives and won Durrington last year.
Uh-huh. So the main issue, as you say, is going to be rubbish collection.
It's always a sort of top issue, and it's all about trust as well. You know, the election leaders from the Conservatives last year made it very clear they were very proud to maintain their weekly collections. Literally within a few months after the election last year, they suddenly decided that actually they wanted to introduce alternate weekly collection. So it really is a trust issue. Clearly there needs to be a change. The current system of refuse and recycling collection isn't working. We have one of the worst recycling rates anywhere in the country, compared to Ada some years ago, which was one of the first councils in the country under Liberal Democrat rule, uh-huh, to introduce curbside recycling. For us to end up with Ada and Worthing being one of the worst is not great at all, really.
You're not standing this time, because you won last time.
I was elected by the good people of Tarring again last time, so I'm election agent and group leader for the Liberal Democrat candidates this year.
So going around the doors at the moment, I assume you've already started door knocking.
We never stop door knocking in Tarring, Mike. You know, it's working all around.
So when you are knocking on the doors, I mean, how much of national politics have taken over what's happening? Brexit sure must be what everyone's talking about.
Oh, absolutely. Certainly the last 3 or 4 months, really, since before Christmas, you know, that's all people, you know, because it's the whole, you know, national picture is just an absolute, you know, Brexit shambles. The whole thing is a complete disaster. Nobody trusts the government. Nobody trusts Her Majesty's opposition, Jeremy Corbyn. Obviously the recent news that they're suddenly sort of sitting down together after 3 years is just a very, very, you know, strange way to carry on. And it's they're almost just sort of cooking up some sort of Brexit deal that actually is going to please nobody, whether you're a Leaver or a Remainer.
Yeah, yeah. So how do you get away from this when you're knocking on the door? I mean, they say they're all talking Brexit.
Absolutely.
It's got nothing to do with you, nothing to do with the local authority. So what, how do you get over this?
Certainly what we do, Mike, we do leaflets about once every month, every 6 weeks in Tarring, and all our leaflets are actually on local issues. You know, I'm a county councillor as well, and I focus on local issues, whether it be county issues such as highways, social services or education, or whether it be the housing cuts that were introduced in the last budget round, whether it be refuse and recycling. That's what we focus on all our literature, and by and large, certainly in my ward, most people just want to talk about those local issues that that we've highlighted in our own newsletters.
Yeah, okay. I mean, are you going to say, so we'll stand up now and say how the seats are going to go? You've got 11 seats. Yeah. How many of those are Conservative at the moment?
Off the top of my head, it's about 17. No, my problem might even be more than that. Looking at the numbers, but the Conservatives have got a substantial majority at the moment. Labour over the last, since the by-election just over a year ago, that they took a further four seats last year, so they've got five seats for the first time in 40 years. The Conservatives still got a substantial majority. There's a Conservative who's sitting as an independent at the moment. There's the one UKIP councillor still here as well as the two Liberal Democrats.
Two Liberal Democrats, yeah.
Councillor Hazelthorpe will be the mayor next month, and also myself as group leader. We're obviously hoping to gain the third seat in Tarring, which we lost on general election day 4 years ago. Senior Tory councillor Tom Wise has not done a good job over the last 4 years, actually, working with us in Tarring, albeit for a different party. He's not standing, and we're really hoping the Liberal Democrats can to take that third seat. So that we can get back to putting people for politics right in the heart of Worthing.